In this video, we will learn to convert the complex number 1 plus 2 times I upon 1 minus 3 times I in the polar form. Here, I is the imaginary unit. Let us assume ZB equal to 1 plus 2 times I upon 1 minus 3 times I. Let us first rationalize the complex number, multiplying the numerator and the denominator of a fraction by a common factor does not change the value of the fraction. So, let us multiply the numerator and the denominator by a common factor 1 plus 3 times I. Thus, Z becomes 1 plus 2 times I times 1 plus 3 times I upon 1 minus 3 times I times 1 plus 3 times I. Let us expand 1 plus 2 times I times 1 plus 3 times I. So, the numerator becomes square of 1 plus 3 times I plus 2 times I plus 6 times square of I. In the denominator, we have 1 minus 3 times I times 1 plus 3 times I, which is equal to square of 1 minus square of 3 times I. We know square of imaginary unit I is equal to minus 1. So, application of the above fact gives us Z is equal to 1 plus 5 times I minus 6 upon 1 minus of minus 9. Further simplification gives us Z is equal to minus 5 plus 5 times I upon 10. Cancelling out the common factor 5 in the numerator and the denominator gives us Z is equal to minus 1 plus I upon 2, which can be written as minus half plus half times I. The complex number Z can be represented in polar form as R times cosine of theta plus I times sine of theta. Here, R is equal to modulus of Z and R times cosine of theta is equal to minus half and R times sine of theta is equal to half. As per the definition, modulus of Z is equal to square root of minus half plus square of half. So, modulus of Z is equal to square root of 1 upon 4 plus 1 upon 4. Further simplification implies modulus of Z is equal to square root of 2 upon 4. Above implies modulus of Z is equal to 1 upon square root of 2, which is equal to R. As we know, R times cosine of theta is equal to minus half, so 1 upon square root of 2 times cosine of theta is equal to minus half. Cancelling out the common factor 1 upon square root of 2 both sides gives us cosine of theta is equal to minus 1 upon square root of 2. Similarly, we get sine of theta is equal to 1 upon square root of 2. We know cosine of 3 times pi upon 4 is minus 1 upon square root of 2 and sine of 3 times pi upon 4 is 1 upon square root of 2. So, the polar form of complex number 1 plus 2 times I upon 1 minus 3 times I is equal to 1 upon square root of 2 times cosine of 3 times pi upon 4 plus I times sine of 3 times pi upon 4. Thank you for being with me. I hope you like this video. Please click the like button and subscribe button. Do not forget to press the notification bell so that you get the notifications of my new videos. Share the video and do write in the comments. I am eager to listen to your thoughts. If you have any question related to video, if you think I should make a video on any other topics in which you are interested, please write in the comments. Thank you.